Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play War on the Sea in the U.S. Campaign, episode number 29, I think? Really, man, the episode numbers just keep on climbing, as do the Japanese death rates. Or death toll, I should say. I guess the rate is more or less the same, infinite, every day. Now, that's, again, a bit hyperbolic. Now, laziness has subsided for the moment, so we should see a huge swarm of aircraft flooding the seas. Well, the sky is over the sea, hopefully not flooding the sea itself. Also, dog, after I think a guy just launched about 4 Wildcats. Now, that's Hornet. Enterprise herself has actually launched all but, maybe it's like 6 of hers? Oh yeah, so she still has 6 Wildcats in reserve, and now I actually have to start doing this. Because we're actually encountering air cover, which is cool, this is great. As far as I know, the best thing to do is to launch your Wildcats first, because they have a 0-minute cooldown. So we're going to launch the next wave of Dauntlesses with support. So these guys kind of have to zigzag, I guess, to like make it so that they don't get there too much faster. I guess it also is nice coverage. And then let's go to UF7 and then launch the 10 Dauntlesses. I did check, and there are zero aircraft, assault aircraft left on the Enterprise. What I mean is naval airstrike aircraft. And I know that somewhere over here is the other cruiser group. So obviously it's going to be much more difficult now that we have this, this cruiser group has gone ahead and tried to leave the area. So originally I was thinking, pull back, and let's see, I think I can get... You have to figure out which order the ships are in and then hit F7 until you get the one you want. Is this one? Yeah, there it is. So I originally was having this group retreat, but now that they're, the enemy's retreating, I move forward. It's such a... I'm following the trap as old as time, I guess. Where if your enemy retreats, that means surely they must be defeated, so that means I should attack. A trick that many clever tacticians have used to their advantage. That being said, I know that the AI is far from clever. Really anything but clever, so in this case it's probably okay for me to do this. What else do we have going on? There's one other thing I want to do. Oh, no, I think we just jump right into the fight. That's what I want to do before we get to the Dauntlesses moving forward. We got to do this fight here. So, to the tactical map we go. This will be our first joint strike between Dauntless... Yeah, there they are. I was like, oh my gosh, please tell me that you made it. But, yeah, they did. So, how many Avengers do we have? 7, and 1 Kingfisher, 1 lone Kingfisher, which I would like to navigate over here. I don't know if he'll... It looks like he's going to be outside the range of combat, but that's okay. We'll make do. As far as the Dauntlesses go, they've been really far from successful in their normal dive bombing patterns, which has given us, I think, something a little bit more historical. What I would actually expect if it was historical is like a ton of misses, and then every now and then like a ton of hits, because it seems like when they hit, they all hit. But it's like you either killed them or you didn't. Cue the numerous examples of that not being true, but that's my like recollection of history. Who are you to tell me otherwise? All right, so I'm gonna continue with the same approach as we've been doing. Vic from the side. Look, none of the approaches are very effective. Do you know what the most effective approach is? Dive bombing. Level bombing. So, since we're not going to do that, let's move these guys up the coast. Kind of do something like this. Have these guys speed up to 170, maybe, to close the gap a little bit. And have 9 speed up to... God, where did you guys go? I guess probably like there. Here instead, and you guys speed up to like 175, and hopefully we can quickly close up the formation a bit. I still don't like bombing with more than 3. I know this drove somebody nuts in the comments. I don't do them in order. The reason I do this is because if I wanted to regroup everyone, it would be a pain in the bum. So if I wanted it to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, everybody would have to do new formations. Doing it this way, I only have to break and reform one formation, which is just... I think it's better in the game to do this. I also think it's... Well, I don't think. I know it's easier on me. Let's switch over to the Avengers and see what we want to do. Now, the Avengers have more of a distance to cover, so I think that we're okay to go in Vic formation, immediately target and attack the enemy ships. Okay, well, just move this way then, and hit the deck. So, I give the order right here. I'll give the order right here. Have these guys speed up. Same way, we just want them to catch up a little bit before making the approach. And 4 and 3, this is like a really good combination. The ideal would be if I was actually able to do two attacks against the cruisers. However, this hammer-anvil type approach, where we're attacking from one side and they're attacking the other, obviously torpedoes are going to be limited in their ability to attack the lead ship. Now, it's possible... Let me see, where the Dauntless is going? Okay, I guess it's possible for me to approach at a different angle. Let me do it, too. So, let me just approach up here. If we approach from a different angle, we actually can nose on with them. It'll be like a 45 degree angle, in which case we can get torpedoes on the two heavy cruisers. So let's do something more like this then. And give you new orders. You don't have to do that to such an extreme, something like that. Alright, now this is going to require a bit of micromanagement, obviously. Oh, and you need to hit the deck as well. Okay, we got him. That looks good. Alright, everything's looking good. These guys are probably going to get flak bursts right away. To be expected. Okay, these guys are forming up. Everything's looking good. In fact, I want you all to continue a little bit further. Something like this. Oh, and I need to make sure that 5 cuts a little bit in. And then 9 cuts in a little bit further. And I have no idea where 4. I have no idea where 4 is going to end up in this, but into something like this. This should be okay. And I might even just send 2 groups against... Oh man, this is a lot of flak. I might even send 2 groups against the heavy cruisers. One of the heavy cruisers. You know what? Let's have you guys pull off and... Well, I'm actually going to save you for later. Not ideal in a lot of ways, but that's just the way I'm going to play this. Now, how are my torpedo bombers doing? They are a little bit faster. I need to buy a little bit more time, though. What I can do to buy myself time is actually have these guys speed the heck up. Where are our comrades? Oh! The shadows for us, where are they? Okay, they're right behind. Okay, good. So let's put these guys almost up to max, and then put this group actually up to max. And let's also get the first group, higher group, to get a little bit lower. And this is going to be good. I like the angle here. Now, let's go ahead and give dive bombing orders. Target. So 1 targets them. Go. 5 is going to target... them, go, and 9, you are going to target, I don't know, one of them was heavily damaged, right? I don't want to target that one. Looks like that's the one that's heavily damaged, so let's target this one. Okay, now the only thing I forgot to do is get 4, 8, and 12 to form up in Vic. So I still, well, you know what, let's do line abreast this time. That, I think that that has a potential to be as good. The reason I prefer Vic is generally because if you miss, if this one overshoots the rear, you'll end up kind of, you know, just straddling the target with bombs, which is fantastic. So that's a good thing. Although you guys aren't even making the first attack run. Anyway, let's move back to the Avengers, which is now all eyes are on them. Target. And that's looking good. Let's give the order to attack. and go to 18. Them target. Good, and attack. All right, here we go. So if you were a Japanese ship right now, you would be thinking, oh my god, we're totally boned. This is awesome. A joint strike, it's working. Timing is not perfect, but pretty good. Dive bombers are nosing over. And the ones who are taking the brunt of the fire, which is good, is these. First bombs on target. Oh wow, look at that. So that is exactly why we choose Vic formation. Unfortunately, in this case, it didn't work out perfectly, but it's the splash pattern is perfect. It's exact. So if one misses by too far, you'd expect that the rear ones... It's like they just perfectly missed. Anyway, they all would have missed, or the none of them missed. But anyway, and the torpedoes are in the water. Perfect. This is actually perfect. In fact, we're in danger. Thank God this isn't a thing, but we're in danger of actually having the two groups collide. So let's give the order to follow waypoint. Speed on out of here. Climb. Likewise. Speed on out of here and climb. Just want to make sure that they are doing that. Good. And last but not least, we got to get our dive bombers out of here as well. So you guys are peeling off in the correct direction. I'm sure that's completely accidental, but it'll work this time. So this way, and climb. Next, we want to start targeting, or start choosing the next dive bombers in. I mean, look at this. It's perfect. They just dropped their bombs. We're dropping our bombs. Hits! Good hits! Torpedoes in the water. Oh boy, the torpedoes are going to miss that one, but they are going to hit this group. Good hits over here, too. Start controlling them. So one. Head this way. Maximum speed, maximum altitude. Five, I think you're the only other ones, and you've all done it. Fantastic job. That, maximum speed, maximum altitude. And that leaves us only with group four over here. Get them up to maximum speed, and let's actually have them start making their approach in all the chaos. Oh, we got a hit. Oh, we got hits. We got hits. We got four hits on number one, zero on number two. So that's obvious for us right now. Now, I want to do this actually pretty quickly. We're obviously going to want to prioritize, oh my god, they might actually go through and hit the other ship. They'll have to really pick up their speed if they want to do that, but it's possible. No, it doesn't look possible. So this is a goner. This is, you write her off. She's done. Dive bomb hits. Four torpedoes, none of them duds. Actually, we only hit her with one bomb, and two was only hit with two bombs. And zero hits on this ship, which she got the near misses actually are going to do some damage. And they did in this case. We can probably go back even with guns. I mean, this has been a very good, very successful. The torpedoes are really pulling their weight. And wait a second. Oh, she's just going to avoid them. Look at that last maneuver. It was perfect to avoid them. Okay. Back over to four. Now... How much damage had she already sustained? Had she already sustained damage? Because it's possible. I'm going to actually pull off four. You know what? I'm just going to circle. Oh, wow. One's already down. Well, not surprising, I guess. One is already down. It would be nice to see them capsize. Oh, my goodness, the water is shallow here. Holy cow. That is very shallow water. I guess the kind of good thing about that is, well, is that like maybe it could be like 30 meters. If you were sucked down by the ship going under, you might actually be able to survive going back to the surface. Okay, so this one's out. This one is about to. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh ho, ho, ho. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh yeah. She's sank her. Who sank who? Oh my gosh. Did she sank her? Oh my gosh, what's happening? Who's sunk here? Three. Which one's three? Oh, I think it's her. I don't even know. Oh gosh, that was too much. Yeah, very shallow resting place. I kind of wish that, like in Silent Hunter, it used to lock you to the bottom. If I remember correctly, at least. Yeah, this one's just gonna rest slowly. Yeah, definitely, you could definitely survive when that one goes down. It's so shallow, you could actually swim back to the surface. I still don't know who of these ships is sunk. I guess this one is. And four is gonna continue on her merry way. Yeah, I probably should give orders. Let me actually just get all the Dauntlesses that are not in this group. 7, 9, 10, 11. To form up in box formation. Let's go down to 8,000. And let's just start circling, just so we don't run off the field of combat, field of battle. We're going to do the same thing with the Avengers. Just get all of them to form up into Vic formation. Box formation. Slow down quite a lot. 8,000 feet is good enough. And again, just start making lazy laps around while we figure out what 14 is going to do. Should buy us some time at least. I mean, what 4 is going to do. Alright, so what the... That was just... It's actually not sunk. This is so bizarre. It's not actually sunk. Like 3... She's not actually sunk, but I guess she is. We can strafe her to make it more convincing, maybe? Oh, there she is. Oh, now she's capsizing. Nice. That's what I wanted to see. Honestly, a great place to be going down. If you're going to go down on a ship, might as well go down in waters that are... Honestly, you could probably... Well, that might be a little deep to swim. Yeah, probably... Well, I mean, some people could get to the bottom. I don't think I could. 30 meters. What's next? Okay, so now we got to come in against number 2. And the good news is, our yip-yapping away and lack of action for a little bit has caused her to separate from the group a fair amount. So once 4 makes her run, I actually think we'll do it this way. Want to get... perfectly perpendicular to her before making my run in. For all we know, she's going to go down anyway, so it's still nice to kind of buy time. Yeah, she's actually riding really low in the water. Oh, another collision. Another collision. Oh, yep. She's going under. Just kidding. Nope, not kidding. Yep, she's... Well, the rear is definitely taking on a lot of water. 4, who was actually underwater, is not anymore. Yeah, this looks good though. I think we'll make our approach once we come alongside. Turn on in. Beautiful shot though. Alright, lead on in. Here we go. Who's this? Is that the remains of number 1? Hard to see what's going on here. Oh, wow. Is she underwater? Is she dead, too? Because she sure looks like it. Anyway. Main action here. Not even opening up on her. Okay, there it is. Now they're coming in. Diving on in. Okay, I heard them kind of slow off on the throttle. I want them to do that. Oh, good hits. How did that one miss that way? How many hits was that? Wow, that should be game over. That's a lot of hits. Yep, she's going down right away. Very good. So this fleet has just been wrecked. And there are two of the last three. I have no idea which one's which again, but not that hard to find out. We have the... Was this the Mogami? No, this was the Takao. And that means the Mogami has already sunk. Identify her from the grave. Yeah, so invert that. No, this one faces backwards. This is the Mogami. One funnel. Backwards. So this was the Mogami. Yeah, this one faces forwards. So this is the Takao. Just in time to see her kind of rolling over. Well, very, very, very successful. And a little bit of luck, of course. Oh, yep, that's actually really cool the way this one sunk, very slowly. I really like that. I don't really know if I like the method of it sinking, but... So this group is actually pretty well damaged, too, because of all the collisions and such. We just have such a huge force. I wonder if we could do something crazy, like actually get all of them to strafe a target. Now, the reason why I'm suggesting this is because the amount of... Oh my gosh, this thing is almost in the water herself. The amount of damage done so far has been so much, and we've thinned out most of their ships. So I think, believe it or not, that I'm going to do it. Okay, if I give an attack order to you, will you just automatically give it to all your subordinates? Now, I want to break off anybody who's... This is a combat box? Makes sense. But I want to break off the people who are wounded. You're obviously wounded. This is number 10. And we have 5 and 7. So 5, 7, 10 need to disengage. 5, 7, 10. Have them form up into Vic. I wonder what happens if you choose Vic from, like, a huge number. Okay, let's do that. And that means that you all are going to form up into... Combat box still makes sense to me. Okay, well, let's try something like Vic. Form up. Slow down. And let's give an order to attack number 6. This is a lot of aircraft. Let them form up first, though. And they are. We'll do the same thing with the Avengers. We'll send them in against number 4. Okay, well, lost contact, but head back this way. And like I said, similarly, these guys... their way in. Oh, they're way out of the picture, so we actually need you guys to speed up. But yeah, then let me also grab the ones who have taken any damage, which is in this case 16 and 18 and 20. So all the even numbers. You guys make your way out. Maybe the Avengers shouldn't even go in. If we slow down enough with the Dauntlesses, they might get there at similar times. I love this formation though. What's going on? Is somebody missing? Missing man formation or something? Oh, I think what happens is maybe this is the most they're... No, they definitely probably should be one. Oh, it's still coming. Well, if we slow down enough. Oh, there's three more coming? Okay, that makes sense. It does look like there's more room, actually, than just one. See the smoke off in the distance? That's always cool. Kingfisher, you need to decline. So thank you for actually providing... You're the only one spotting the aircraft right now, believe it or not. Which is pretty cool. You're doing your job. Let's get you to climb a little bit more, though. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this thing is... Gosh, I'm just really shocked she isn't already sinking. Then we have four, and then we have five. Yeah, we might actually be able to make it out with all six of these ships. That would be really something. Five is the least damage. So what I want is, I want the Avengers to go after number six. I mean, man, she's just so... I feel like we could pick her off. She's like a straggler. I feel like we could pick her off and then have everyone else come back, come back in. Anybody who's not damaged come back in to do the real damage. Or I could just... No, I don't want to risk... Let's not risk it. I don't want to risk it. We don't need to take that many chances. Let's just... I'm pretty sure that we're okay to do it this way. That's nice. This is a nice formation. And the Avengers are still trying to make up for lost ground. Very, very quickly. Let's have you form up into Vic as well. And I can speed this up a little bit. Yeah, we're actually going to get there just about on all together. In fact, Dauntlesses can now speed up. Okay, so Dauntlesses, your orders are to target number 6. If I give you... Let's see how this works. If I give you an order, are they all going to break? Good, that's fine. Perfect. Avengers, your orders are to attack number 4. Wow, that's really cool. The water's really nice and clear here. And they're smoking underwater. I'm not sure if that's really how it would go. Maybe. So unfortunately the Avengers are going to end up taking the fire that I would really rather have the Dauntlesses take. And honestly, the Avengers are really capable with their torpedoes. I used to like the Dauntlesses better, but I have to say that Avengers have impressed me a lot. Looking for smoke right now, so I can pull off any of the wounded ones. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh, I don't think that that's going to be a survivor. Let's actually get the Dauntlesses to maybe they can continue their strafing run. Oh, they can. You know it. Okay, let's have them form Vic. Break right. Ah, damn it. One Avenger down. Let's see if it's worth it, though. It might actually still end up being worth it. Oh, wow. That's some good fire. It's just... You have so many of them. It's just so potent. Too bad their rear gunners didn't do anything. What is this guy doing? Did we lose another one? Are you number one? Pull up, my man. Pull up. Good. Got out of there. Okay, let me micromanage these guys so they don't go back in. That was really good damage. I think we'll end up getting some kills out of this, but I'm not sure. Oh, gosh. Okay, so let's let them go a little bit further out of the way. I know that they are basically turning back in the direction I don't want them to turn back, but I guess I can give orders manually. Oh, there's too many of them. Don't do it. Don't go back. Alright. At this point, we'll have to just give individual orders. Look, if there was a better way of doing this, I'm happy to hear it, but I unfortunately don't think there is. You guys have actually gone so far back as to be a target again? Okay, 3, 11, 12. Let's just do this way. 3, 11, 12. Form up in Vic. And number 3, your orders are to move this way. Actually, even more extreme, move that way and increase your altitude. Let's see what we have going on here. Okay, this is good. So fires are happening aboard the destroyer. If she has taken damage, then it's quite possible that she won't have as good of firefighting capability, and she may end up, going down for it. This looks really good, and I did see some nice explosions. Considering she's already wounded, might get some luck out of this one too. I think having only lost one Avenger, I'm going to call this a successful mission, but I don't think we're going to risk another strafing run. They do seem really, really overpowered. So we'll see what the effect of this is. All those aircraft are free to disengage, basically. We can send in another bombing run eventually, see what happens. That. Alright, let's keep tabs on the burning ones. I see fire on deck. This might actually be two victories. Well, she's put out her fire. Maybe. Yeah, I think that's just the flame or the funnel exhaust, basically. Though it does look like... Oh yeah, there are two funnels. So she's managed to do okay. Nah, I don't know about this light cruiser, though. I don't think she's going to make it. So, in the end, only two destroyers? Well, good thing, at least, that we don't have to worry about submarines. As in, my submarine is not on the... is not chasing this group. It's the only thing that, really, this group threatens at this point. Oh, wow, that was a whole episode just on this, and it was a lot of fun. But let me cut away... So, I mean, we're going to do some more. We got some more lined up in this one. Don't worry. I'll just cut away, and we'll see what happens with these ships. Actually, I'm not even going to wait. I'm just going to go ahead and disengage now, because it looks like the light cruiser is under control. So, all right. 37 command points. That's awesome. Basically, we can make our new battleship group now. The light cruiser, which survived, has heavy, heavy damage. One of the destroyers has minor, and the other destroyer has heavy. In fact, the older destroyer has heavy, but the more modern destroyer only has minor damage. Lost one aircraft for it. I think that everyone would agree that that was a fantastic result. We're definitely willing to lose one Avenger for the loss of two of the last three heavy cruisers, as well as a light cruiser. Very good result. Now, that means almost all the heavy cruisers and the Japanese force are now resting in the Guadalcanal theater on the bottom of the ocean. So what was it? One Mogami left? No, it's the Takao. Okay. So the Chokai is the last remaining target for us. After that, well, it'll be interesting to see what the Japanese throw at us next. Okay, Tambor, where's okay. We have to do this. Are we beaming on the surface? We aren't, which is very interesting. Okay. We have a submarine. Combat. Probably some destroyers out looking for us. Though I honestly don't see anything. Although I know which way which direction we have to go. So we need to, yeah, come hard to port, and we need to look this way for the enemy. See anything? I mean, we just need to move towards the middle of the circle, right? This is how we want to do this. Since I'm not sure we're going to find anything, I am happy to pause and I'll let you... We'll come back in. By the way, what's the weather? Oh yeah, look at this sea state. That's great sea state for a submarine, at least. We're pretty much invisible then. Ocean bottom, deep... Okay. Yeah, so I'll cut away, and I'll come back if we can find anything. Well, this is truly remarkable. We did find something, and it was somehow right behind us. So we didn't find it yet, but I found it on Periscope. So I want to slow down to 7 or so. Yeah, I mean, we don't have this as a target yet, but we should pretty soon. That they might actually even be outside the engagement range. They're to our right. I mean, they're basically just coming in from the out of the map. We're going to set ourselves up for a torpedo attack. Really good conditions for us to get in, get out. Get in, attack, and get out. If they don't disappear for being, like, you know, outside the engagement range or whatever, there is a... So if they're up here, they might just time out. I really hope they don't. As... This would be wonderful. Yeah, they, like, seem, like, harder to get to than... Let's go 9 knots. Are they turning? No. Nose in this way. Yeah, we need to turn. Let's turn hard. Harder. Must be just... Actually, they might be leaving the border soon, so I need to go in. What I could do, you know, the really intelligent thing to do here would be to wait for the destroyers to roll off the map and then go ahead and attack them once they have no escorts. You know, not on the surface. Those merchants have proven they are, like, incredibly dangerous on the surface. But looks about right. They will be moving pretty slow. It's so funny that I was actually... I should have been, like, practically right on top of them. Now, this is a merchant group. I was kind of hoping to see maybe some battleships or something like that. Because obviously we don't know... I mean, at this point, we don't know what the Japanese are going to send. They have no more heavy cruisers. I don't think I'll be launching torpedoes at the destroyers as much as I would like to. The problem with doing that is just simply the keel. The draft is too shallow, what I should say. So, Let me get into position, and I will bring you back when I can launch. Okay, we're lining up a solution on the Kagero, which is the lead destroyer. And once that gets above, well, I guess once it gets to here, since it's not getting any better at this point, we're going to launch when it's at 89, and I'm going to be launching with the rear torpedoes. So we're going to do two at a spread of, I don't know, 2 degrees. If I get lucky, we'll get lucky, right? Could possibly hit her. Oh, did I see? We'll just fire it like this. So these are my rear torpedoes, mind you. It's a little bit bizarre, but you can do this in this game with, like, 220 degree gyro angle or something, I don't know. Now we have to quickly target this ship, and we have to get this solution pretty quickly. Switch to the fronts. I think two torpedoes, well, let's do three torpedoes because you never know. There is always the Lady Luck and Dud torpedoes. Now, I suspect that even though these have to turn around and all that, we should be okay, and they actually probably have a further distance to go, so this is pretty well planned out. I want them to obviously hit at more or less the same time. Solution's getting up there. Just really need to time it with the torpedoes more than anything. Probably, I want those to hit first, so I'm gonna let them get a little bit of steam and then we'll fire. These actually have a ways to go, so we gotta give them a little more time. Do we have? Well, no, I don't think I will. I was gonna think I should have targeted this one, launched three, and then targeted this one, launched another three, but that's fine. Alright, next time we get 90%, I'm gonna go ahead and launch. This is a little bit crazy. I want to go quickly over this way now. And we'll start targeting the other one. They're moving pretty slow, right? 9 knots, so. Well, you never know. Might get lucky here. Just need to get out of the position where we launched from, because that's like the biggest thing in this game. Good news is the weather's really going to work to our advantage. So the question is here, one, do we get a dud, and two, do they go underneath the ship? Now in this sea state, I don't know if it works to our advantage or disadvantage, honestly. I think it works to our advantage because the ship should be kind of, I mean if it... Oh, did we miss? Shame on you, Mr. Solution. That is definitely going to be a miss. Which, I guess, means we just end up picking another target. Eh, they were probably going to go underneath her keel anyway. That's what I'll tell myself, but those are definitely a miss. Wow, so don't trust the... I know that was an 88% solution. Normally those are just, like, way too good, even. And which is the reason why people have been maligning me in the comments the whole series for choosing a spread angle too small. The one time I don't do it, I should for sure have done it. Now these look really good. So we're on a really good solution as well, are we not? What's the deal? Oh, our solution is really good. Oh, let me identify it. Darn it, you see ding-dongs. Of course, identify it. Okay, does that help your solution at all? Give me a solution pretty quickly here. Increase the spread quite a bit. Okay, struck by a torpedo. Dud. They're turning, yeah. So that's it. That's going to be all for this. We could still fire at one of these rear ones. Or even the destroyers when they decide to come hunting. But I think we're just going to get the hell out of here first. Knowing that we are basically very, very quiet, considering how incredibly, incredibly noisy the water is right now. Yeah, really high wind, sea state 6. I feel like we shouldn't have any problems getting out of here. Might even want to swim back towards the enemy. Get ourselves lost among the transports here. Also, that's it is slightly more perpendicular to the incoming destroyer angle, I believe. We just need to keep an eye on them. Basically, if they move right towards us, then we know that we need to shift one way or the other. Pretty much right at me, which is unfortunate. The real game of this is, in my opinion, just making sure that you don't get exactly run over by the destroyer. Okay, she is not heading towards us now. She's heading, well, she's heading for us, but we will be gone from this position before she gets here. So that's good. And with any luck, we might actually be able to get some extra torpedoes off. It's too bad, man. If we had done a spread of like 5 degrees, which I normally do, something like that, we probably would have hit the first destroyer. Again, it probably would have gone under, or it would have been a dud, but at least it would have been more satisfying than missing entirely. This looks good. And four is kind of turning around, like, okay, forget. Start current target, stop. Target number four. Is she turning towards us, though? She is actually tracking us. I think. Okay. Well, radar down, scope down, and let's dive down to 200 or so. See if that makes any difference. She definitely seems like she's pursuing us. Oh, wow. Whew. Yeah. Just missed her. And again, I'm not worried about noise. I'm only worried about actives in this situation. So we'll take the full 9 knots. Got ourselves down to 280, which is going to help. First one zagged instead of zigging, which we're thankful for. Yeah, and now we can probably... Well, I don't know. We'll probably just... I'm just going to leave the scene here. I'm not going to go too crazy. Should be okay. I know that I would love to go and launch torpedoes, but we can play this one a little bit safe and have, for once, a successful submarine hunt mission. Yeah, we're all good. It even gave me leave in 0 seconds. Don't even have to wait. Okay, good. So we sank one more. Fantastic. 5 more command points. Tamber's out of there. Tamber's also getting a little bit low on torpedoes. We'd have to go back to Port Moresby to rearm her. It's funny, because the Thresher was just coming over to join her. We're going to start wolfpacking a little bit more. Anyway, I do have more stuff I want to cover, like the Gato's attack and all that, but we're up to 49 minutes here, so I think we're just going to have to let these aircraft... By the way, I didn't show it, but let me at least do this real fast. Our aircraft patrol patterns, so you can see what all is going on. Pretty broad coverage all over the place. I'm still nervous about this submarine that we let go, so trying to do as much as we can down there. Anyways, that'll do it for this episode. Thanks for watching, and until the next one, stay safe and take care.